Hey folks, welcome to Wall Street Mojo's investment banking tutorial, and today's topic is book value per share. So book value per share is a relatively simple topic, and it is used to ascertain if the stock is overvalued or if it is, you know, undervalued. So primarily book value is used there, but you can also use the book value to find out the ROE for a particular stock. Alright, so let's look at the computation of book value, and then we would look at, you know, how this formula would be useful. Alright, so when you talk about the computation, you have book value per share as the total assets less the total liabilities, and which leaves us with the total common stockholders' equity. And if there is preferred stock, that too has to be deducted from the overall stockholders' equity, which means what? Which means that the amount of value which is left to the investors, like the basic equity investors. So that is the importance of, you know, deducting the preferred stock value from the overall stockholders' equity. And that divided by the number of common shares outstanding would give us the book value per share. So let's try and understand and look at the value for book value per share for a company. So let's say Apple. So let's go to Edgar and find the company with the ticker symbol, which is APPL, I guess. Yeah, Apple Computers. So APPL. Let's search it from here. So Apple Inc. And let's look at the 10Q. We just need the value from the balance sheet, so 10Q would do. It's the quarterly, it's the balance sheet, so it doesn't matter if it is quarterly or annual, it's just on a given day. So let's go down here, find out the value for total assets is $367 billion, and the total liabilities is $240 billion. So now let's just come here, open it in Excel, and find out the book value. So book value is going to be total shareholders or stockholders, whatever, equity by the number of shares outstanding. So total shareholders equity is directly given at times, and you can also calculate it by doing this: total assets less total liabilities. Alright, so if we look at the book value for Apple Computers, let's look at it here. So the total assets is this, and total liabilities is this, and the stockholders' equity is $126 million. So this $367 billion less $240 billion would give us $126 billion. And out of this, if they had like some preferred stock value, you should have deducted that as well. So it's pretty lame to do this, but you know, wow. So total stockholders equity by the number of shares outstanding. So shares outstanding would be, so this is total assets, and this is total liabilities, and this is total stockholders' equity. And the number of shares outstanding would be given somewhere here. So the number of shares outstanding is Yeah, so diluted shares outstanding for 3 months ended 31st March 18 is this much, and I think these are in millions as well. Except the number of shares which are reflected in thousands and per share amount. So these are in thousands. Okay, so this value here. So this is the number of shares in absolute terms and the book value per share, which is BVPS. It's going to be total stockholders' equity by this. And now we'll have to adjust this value because this value is in $1 billion. And this value is in absolute terms. So we'll have to change this value in billion. Or maybe you can just leave it, you know, just put the numbers here. Okay. So what happened? So I guess we'll have to, you know, change the values here. So this is in billions. Now we will also convert this in absolute. So this would be this particular number here. Yeah. And again, this would be this particular number. So 240 billion. This is again in absolute terms. Absolute terms this, and this is going to be, so that the book value comes out to be $25 per share. So now we'll get back to the website and find out the other uses of book value. So book value, we have seen the computation, and if you look at the book value for Google, it has been growing at a very steady rate from 2010 onwards. All right. And the second part here, yeah, so yeah, the uses of book value. So the uses of book value is to calculate, the first use is to calculate the price to book value. So now if you know the value, or rather the price of the stock, which is Apple computers, you can find out the ratio of price to book value. So the first use is use number one to calculate the price to book value. So this would be the stock price of the Apple computers would be, can be taken from the website like Google Finance. Yeah, so it is $183. It is trading at $183, and the book value per share we have calculated is $25. So the price to book value is 183 divided by this value here, so which is 7.3 times. 7.3 times the book value. That means what? This stock is like overvalued. Overvalued. So investors are seeing something which is not, you know, given in the balance sheet. You know, they are seeing some value there, right? This is 7 times the normal book value of the company. And if you can justify this, then you should put in your money there. All right. So this is one use. The second use is to calculate the ROE per share. So ROE is nothing but the EPS by the book value per share. So use two, use number two, or, and this was use number one. So to calculate the ROE per share. So ROE per share is net income per share. So net income per share is what? Earnings per share. EPS by BVPS. So EPS we can calculate here. It might be given here somewhere. So earnings per share, diluted earnings per share is 2.73. So 2.73 by the book value per share is this. So if you convert it in percentage terms, you'll get the return. So the ROE, return on equity, is 10.91%. 10.91%. So these are the two uses for book value per share. All right, the one first use is to find out the price to book value. This is a ratio which helps us ascertain whether the stock is overvalued or undervalued. Then the second use is to find out the return on equity, which is the return the shareholders, the equity shareholders, are getting. All right, so I hope you have enjoyed this, and bye for now.